to introduce little girl Gormley. Cuties. To introduce the cuties, we have Abigail.
Alexandra.
Sis, what's your name?
Monet.
We have Monet. And Maisha, these girls have travelled around the whole UK celebrating their remix to When Jesus Says
Yes.
And now I'm going to pass over to the ladies. Boom, 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 boom. One, two, three, go.
I'm not worried about a thing, cause I know you are guiding me.
You guys have to say with the cuties performance.
It was amazing.
And we have to
guys,
say,
guys, these are your fans.
Your fans. I'm your number one fan. I'm your number one. And we have to say, they definitely delivered. And Victoria Zibike has to say, you have made it through to the next round.
Oh my gosh, it's so nice to be back here with you guys. Some of you may be thinking, who are you? Or some of you may be thinking, yes, I remember you. So I'm Victoria. I was a kids worker last year. So I was at Elam last year. But now I've, you know, finished university and I've come back to London and I'm joining you guys for Easter Sunday. And I'm so, so, so excited to be here through these screens, all to connect it to all of you guys. I think today is a day that we should be so excited and so happy, regardless of, you know, how difficult, you know, what is going on around us, and maybe you guys feeling, but I don't get to go outside and play, or, you know, it's not that fun. But today is Easter Sunday, and I think that's amazing. So just to rewind, Easter is incredible because this is one of the fundamental, important, essential elements of our faith, that we believe that Jesus rose again. And like, that is amazing, you know, that he rose again for us to understand that he, how much he loves us, but that we don't need to live a life of, you know, regret or being sad, that we can be happy because our Savior is alive today. And that's incredible. So I'm really, really excited to be here with you guys on Easter Sunday. And I think it is amazing to understand, you know, the kind of the process that Jesus went through. Imagine 3 days before going to the cross, how scared and fearful he may have been, but he trusted God and he understood, you know what, I'm not in control of the situation, but Jesus is, but God is. Forgive me, God is in control, and he's going to make sure that whatever happens, he will take care of me. And I really want us to remember this. There's trust in God with all our hearts, just like Jesus did on the cross. And that brings me to my first verse I want to share on Easter Sunday, which is trust in the Lord. Firstly, it's in Proverbs 3, verse 5. Let's trust in the Lord with all your heart. And lean not on your own understanding. And I think this is such an important verse for us all, you know, because we have to learn, especially in a time like this, that we shouldn't trust in ourselves, but instead we should look to someone greater than us to trust. Because what happens, I want to show you something I made for you guys. When we trust in God with all our heart looks like this. We are happy. We may not know what's going on, but we are full because of that, we're joyful, we have peace, and we understand that God is in control of the situation. So, you know, when times, like, for example, now with coronavirus going on, you know, when we trust that God will figure everything out and work it out, that's what we have a good heart full of trust, just like Jesus did when he was going to the cross. Because what happens, it's so easy for us to be filled, especially times like now, with this, with fear, with worry, and with doubts. But Jesus doesn't want this side. He doesn't want a green heart for any of us. He wants us to always understand that when we trust in him, that we can understand that he is always in control and he will always take care of us. So I want us to understand that when you trust, great things happen. And I have another verse that I would love to share with you guys as well, which is in Jeremiah 17. Who likes my singing? Verse 7, which is, but blessed is the man, and we can change that to, blessed is a young girl or young boy who trusts in the Lord, whose confidence is in him. He will be like a tree planted by the waters that sends out its roots by the stream. I just want to stop there because I think this is so, so powerful. When we trust in the Lord, we can be like a big tree that's planted, knit like Christ. And I want to share with you guys, I'm quickly going to finish, not to worry, but I want to share with you guys, I have in my outside, in my window, I have a view of an incredible, beautiful, beautiful tree, and I'm gonna come and show you guys.
I wanted to show you the beautiful tree that is outside of my window, and I think this is so beautiful because it reminds us when we trust, we will be like these beautiful leaves and this beautiful flower and on this beautiful tree. That when, you know, difficult times happen like this, we don't let that stop us from understanding God's full goodness.
So, to finish with you guys now, this tree that's outside of my window just makes me always so happy, and it makes sure that I, you know, it brings out the characteristics of having a heart that trusts the Lord. It makes me happy. It makes me think of, like, you know, all the things to be grateful for that the Lord has done, such as what? Look at our families that, you know, God has made, that God is always good and God will protect us and God loves us fully. So I think what I want you guys to do is spend some time today finding somewhere in your house, just like the tree is for me, a place that brings me so much happiness. Where is somewhere in your house or something or an object? It could be a candle or it could be, you know, something in your room. But what makes you happy and what makes you remember of God's goodness and allows you to have a heart that always fully trusts the Lord? So find that object, thing or room, or like me, it could be a tree in your garden, and like sit down or look at it and spend some time remembering how good our God is, especially on a day like Easter Sunday. I miss you guys, and hopefully when we can go back outside, I will be back. See you soon. Bye.
Happy Easter!